price. One, a minimum support price at the time of sowing, a procurement price at the time of harvest, and a post-procurement adjustment if we really export. So the benefits of export, the additional money which comes, also goes to farmers.
Mr. Sharad Joshi, have we seen farmers really not being able to take advantage of some of the government's policies and really being at the receiving end of the current crisis? Also, given the fact that there continues to be a raging debate as to whether or not exports should be allowed, the government says they cannot distribute those food grains, it's not a practical solution. Will exports not get the farmers a better price for their product?
I would like to make some bullet points. Number one, whether you have an excess production or you have a deficient production is definitely a failure of the statistical system, and neither does any credit to the overall agricultural system. And the more important point that I would like to make is that deficient storage arrangements, particularly warehousing and gunny bagging, etc., are deliberate. I would like to go beyond what Narendra Sharma said. They are deliberate because unless there is some rotting of food, there will be no balancing of account, balancing of procurement as against the distribution. And therefore the FCI can be accused of deliberately causing the rotting of foods in order to be able to match their figures.
Mr. K.K. Narayanan, we often see a whole conflict there between what we term corporate interest versus farmer interest, or the fact that just because the government is exporting, it is considered to be anti-farmer or anti the overall policy of the government in terms of not being able to feed the hungry and still allowing exports to happen. Would you agree with these two divergent views, or do you think corporate interest can merge with farmer interest?
I think I don't agree that corporate interest is anything to farmer in country's interest. In fact, for any responsible corporate who is engaged in the agriculture, they have to keep the farmer's interest foremost in their agenda. But let me get back to the issue of storage of food grains. Like everybody said, this is not just a problem that happened today. It's been happening time and again, and we have heard about stories of food grains rotting. And like several of the other panelists mentioned, there is also, on the other side, you have about 300 million people in this country going to bed hungry. Either they don't have food or they don't have sufficient amounts of food. So this is the cruel paradox that our country is facing. On the one hand, you have rotting mountains of food, and on the other hand, you have so many people going hungry or malnourished. Now, to paraphrase one of the journalists who had written some time ago, I forget the name, I think the mountains of food grains do not represent the surplus of food that we have in our country. It actually represents the surplus of hunger that is there in the country. So we don't have to put in efforts to increase productivity or increase production in this country, because if these food grains, even if we had efficient systems to distribute them, I don't think how many weeks it will take if we have to meet the nutritional needs and the energy needs of the population, of the people of this country. So that left, you know, having said that, I want to say that there should be, I think, better planning. There should be more emphasis on creating the infrastructure that is needed to store these food grains, to distribute them efficiently. So I'm just wondering, why not have a policy which actually promotes, not exclusively, but in parallel to the investments by the government, promote private sector investment in some of these areas, building infrastructure in distribution networks and stuff like that.
Mr. Sinha, very valid suggestion there coming from Mr. Narayan in private sector investment. We always keep talking about public-private sector partnership. Is this a practical suggestion? And also, do we really believe that our agricultural policy right now is more tilted towards suiting corporate interests? Because that's always a charge that comes up.
You know, I suppose a case could be made out for a private sector participation in food grain storage, but I think the rentals would be very high, and the government of India, it will not be viable, because if the corporate sector wants to imitate the kind of good storage that is there in Australia, Canada and USA, I don't think it will be viable. So I have a different point of view. The FCI every year procures between 550 to 600 lakh tons of food grains for the government of India.
Right.
The liquidation of its stocks is only about 350 to 400 lakh tons, which means that every year the net addition is between 100 to 200 lakh tons of food grains.
Right.
So therefore, the solution should be, as Dr. Sharma said, if 300 million children go hungry every night, and as the Supreme Court said, if not distributing the surplus food is a crime, we should, without any further delay, without any further intellectual theorizing, we should implement the food security bill so that ethically, financially and democratically, whatever food grains, the massive food grains that have been procured every year, are also liquidated in a form which would be acceptable to everyone.
Right, you had a point to make.
See, it's very interesting when it comes to storage of food grains and other things. You know, we always talk of bringing in private investment. And I'm not opposed to private investment, but I think we need to understand where exactly it will be important to have private investment, where it will not be important. Now, look at this government's own priorities. You know, there are 2.5 lakh panchayats in this country. For panchayats, nobody is saying that for setting up a panchayat ghar, you need private investment. The government has allocated money for setting or constructing panchayat ghar in every panchayat in India. Now, if they have money for setting up panchayat ghar, please tell me, can't that money go to storing grains or building storage grains at panchayat level? It's a question of priority. The government of India does not want to go in there. It's only, lots of people want private sector to move in there. And you can understand the politics.